Okay. Don't stop for nothing. Okay.
Come on.
Here. Sorry about that, Javik.
You gotta get out of here.
This is where I belong.
Don't argue with me.
But I can still fight.
I need to know somebody's getting out of this alive.
Commander.
I feel bad with Javik not being able to be a part of this, just because he wanted to see this through.
Go!
I wanted him to see this through. He's waited centuries, he's waited millennia for this. You leave the Normandy alone. Nope, I'm still here. Better than they ever did.
Power's wiped out. All forces, retreat. Pull back.
I have some metagel left, actually. I have like four packs of metagel. I realize gameplay story segregation is a thing, but still. It's like the most powerful handgun in the game, apparently, thus far. I didn't know the handgun was this good. I would have just used the handgun the whole time. Well, hey! Ooh. Not going great. Here comes the catalyst. All I gotta do is open up the Citadel so we can dock. I'm not in the...
All fleets converge on the crucible. Protect it at all costs.
Oof. Ow. That is... considering my condition, that is not the best one to get up. I was wearing body armor.
Shepard.
Anderson. You up here too?
I followed you up. But we didn't come out the same place. No. At least I don't think we did. What's your surrounding look like?
Keepers, surrounded.
You okay?
I feel like death, but I'm moving.
Surrounded by husks,
it's dark.
Corpses, and keepers.
There's human remains scattered.
Sounds familiar. I'm in a dark hallway. Reminds me of your description of the collector base.
Makes sense. Them up on Earth and send the people up here to be processed.
Oh, I look like hell.
Goddamn abomination. I'm gonna keep moving. The sooner we blow these bastards back to hell, the better. The troops don't go on forever. But where the hell are we?
Yeah. Doesn't look like any part of the Citadel I've been to.
Presence of the Keepers makes me think this is the Keeper maintenance tunnels.
Anderson?
One of the walls here just realigned itself. The place is shifting, changing. There's a chasm here, and more hallways like the one I was in.
I think I'm near an exit.
Is the council chamber or the former council chamber?
Don't get too far ahead of me.
Find ahead.
Where do you think you're at?
Just found that chasm you were talking about.
Hold on. I see something. A control panel, maybe. I'm just gonna go on.
And lost the signal.
Anderson? Damn it.
Man, I can't save my game. Like a central hub. Oh, hi, elusive man. I'm curious. Oh. Debriefing on the gun I used. Oh, Anderson. Okay.
Anderson.
Shepard. I can't.
I
underestimated.
Ah, there you are, douchebag.
What have you...
I warned you. Control is the means to survival. Control of the Reapers, and of you, if necessary.
They're controlling you.
I don't think so, Admiral.
Controlling me is a lot different.
There we go.
Reaper.
Have a little faith. When humanity discovered the mass relays, when we learned there was more to the galaxy than we...
And you're monologuing.
There were some who thought the relays should be destroyed. They were scared of what we'd find, terrified of what we might let in. But look at what humanity has achieved. Since that discovery, we've advanced more than the past 10,000 years combined. And the Reapers will do the same for us again, a thousandfold. But... Only... can harness their ability to control.
Bullshit. We destroy them, or they destroy us.
And waste this opportunity?
Never. The thing is, that we destroy them or we destroy us, that is the thesis that the creators had, that artificial life and organic life could not coexist. That's not what I'm trying to say.
Power you shouldn't be able to use.
I don't believe that. If we can control it, why shouldn't it be ours?
Because we're not ready.
No. This is the way humanity must evolve.
There's always another way.
I've dedicated my life to understanding the Reapers, and I know with certainty the Crucible will allow me to control them.
And then what?
Look at the power they wield. Look at what they can do.
Oh, you fucker. You made me shoot Anderson. I want to wreck you for this.
I see what they did to you.
I took what I wanted from them. Made it my own. This isn't about me or you. It's about things so much bigger than all of us.
He's wrong.
He's right, but he's wrong about how it works.
And who will you listen to, Shepard? An old soldier stuck in his ways, only able to see the world down the barrel of a gun? And what if he's wrong? What if controlling the Reapers is the answer?
What if you're wrong? You're both taking it from two different sides of the same coin. Complete intolerance and destruction or slavery.
We destroy the Reapers, this ends today. But if you can't control them...
But I can!
Are you willing to bet humanity's existence on it?
I know it will work.
You can't, can you? They won't let you do it.
No! I'm in control! No one...
You're not the boss of me! You're not my real dad!
You're indoctrinated.
No! No! The two of you so self-righteous. Do you think power like this comes easy? There are sacrifices.
You sacrifice too much.
Shepard, I only wanted to protect humanity. The Crucibles can control it. I know it can.
It's not too late. Let us go. We'll do the rest.
I can't do that, Commander.
Of course you can't. They own you now.
You'd undo everything I've accomplished. I won't let that happen.
You're not yourself anymore.
Now, You're the one who failed.
Interesting. They have the reason dialogue options there, but they're not actually functional. Like you can't. He's beyond reasoning. That's an interesting gameplay choice.
You could see it like I do, Shepard. It's so perfect.
Not at the moment, it's not. Because it's been trashed by the Reapers. All right.
This is it, everyone. The arms are open.
Okay. So now we just need to activate this thing.
Commander?
We did it.
Yes, we did. It's quite a view.
Best seats in the house.
God. Feels like years since I just sat down.
Think you earned a rest. Stay with me. We're almost through this.
Turn on the...
You did good, child. You did good. I'm proud of you.
Thank you, sir. Anderson?
Damn. Well... Let's go.
Shepard? Commander?
What do you need me to do?
Nothing's happening. The crucible's not firing. It's gotta be something on your end.
Okay, give me a second. working on it. Come on, get it.
Commander.
There we go. There you go. Now something is happening. Here we go. The big decision.
Wake up. What? Where am I? The Citadel. It's my home. Thought the Citadel was the catalyst. No, the Citadel is part of me. I need to stop the Reapers. Do you know how I can do that? Perhaps I control the Reapers. They are my solution. The solution to what? Chaos.
Ah, okay.
The created will always rebel against their creators. But we found a way to stop that from happening. A way to restore...
This is your fear from the Leviathan races.
No, we harvest advanced civilizations, leaving the younger ones alone. Just as we left your people alive the last time we were here.
But you killed the rest.
We helped them ascend, so they can make way for new life, storing the old life in Reaper form.
I think we'd rather keep our own form.
No, you can't. Without us to stop it, synthetics would destroy all organics.
Except we've...
We've created the cycle so that never happens. That's the solution.
Except we've proven that they can coexist with humanity and the Geth, and with Edie.
Where did the Reapers come from?
Oh, we've covered this already.
My creators gave them form. I gave them function. They, in turn, give me purpose. The Reapers are a synthetic representation of my creators.
Yep, we've covered this in Leviathan DLC. Yeah. Okay.
Yes. They created me to oversee the relations between synthetic and organic life, to establish...
In case you couldn't put two and two together earlier.
They became the first true Reaper. They did not approve, but it was the only solution.
You said that before, but how do the Reapers...
There we go, that's a cool...
Organics create synthetics to improve their own existence, but those improvements have limits. To exceed those limits, synthetics must be allowed to evolve. They must, by definition, surpass their creators. The result is conflict, destruction, chaos. It is inevitable. Reapers harvest all life, organic and synthetic, preserving them before they are forever lost.
But also preventing them from growing further.
We're at war with the Reapers right now.
You may be in conflict with the Reapers, but they are not interested in war.
Find that hard.
Have you considered talking about this?
When fire burns, is it at war? Is it in conflict? Or is it simply doing what it was created to do? We are no different. We harvest your bodies, your knowledge, your creations. We preserve it, to be reborn in the form of a new Reaper. Like a cleansing fire.
But the cleansing fire destroys all in its wake.
New life, both organic and synthetic, can once again flourish.
Yeah, you do not in fact get it.
But you're taking away our future.
And once you are taken inorganic by Reaper, we have no growth.
We might as well be machines, programmed to do.
Which is what you are, which in fact relates to the fundamental conflict that you're trying to stop, and in fact, and failing to stop it.
But it also proves my solution won't work.
Bingo! Because you're...
So now what?
We find a new solution.
Why are you telling me this? Why help me?
You have altered the variables.
What do you mean?
The Crucible changed me, created new... possibilities, but I can't make them happen.
If there is to be a new solution, you must.
All right, and what are my options?
It is now in your power to destroy us. But be warned, others will be destroyed.
Okay.
The Crucible will not discriminate. All synthetics will be.
The Geth and Edie.
Even you are partly synthetic.
What exactly will happen?
Your Crucible device appears to be largely intact. However, the effects of the blast will not be constrained to the Reapers. Technology you rely on will be affected. But those who survive should have little difficulty repairing the damage. There will still be losses, but no more than what has already been lost.
But the Reapers will be destroyed?
Yes, but the peace won't last. Soon, your children will create synthetics, and then the chaos will come back.
There has to be another way.
Okay.
You could instead use the energy of the Crucible to seize control of the Reapers.
And this is the showing here for the.
So the elusive man was right after all.
Yes, but he could never have taken control, because we already controlled him.
But I can.
You will die. You will control us, but you will lose everything you have.
How can I control the Reapers if I'm dead?
Your corporeal form will be dissolved, but your thoughts...
So I'll join the Hive Consciousness. Wow, that was a weird graphical glitch. Like with the Geth.
Your connection to your kind will be lost, though you will remain aware of their existence.
Okay, I appreciate how when we see each of these two options, we see them from the perspective of... we see what Anderson and what the Elusive Man would have gone through, or what they would have tried to do. So, taking the control option is actually probably something closer to the equivalent of what Legion did with the Geth, uploading his consciousness to the entire Geth consensus and persuading them. I realize I'm talking this through with the construction background. Uploaded his consciousness to the Geth consensus, and in the process, introducing them to the concept of individuality and that sort of thing. And that's what would happen if I took the control option. Not slavery or enslavement.
But the Reapers will obey me.
Yes. We will be yours to control and direct as you see fit.
And here's the option three.
Synthesis.
Okay.
And that is...
Add your energy to the Crucibles. The chain reaction will combine all synthetic and organic life into a new framework. A new DNA.
Explain how my energy can be added to the Crucible.
Your organic energy... The essence of who and what you are.
Well, either way, I'm kind of dead.
And then dispersed.
To do what, exactly?
The energy of the Crucible, released in this way, will alter the matrix of all organic life in the galaxy. Organics seek perfection through technology. Synthetics seek perfection through understanding. Organics will be perfected by integrating fully with synthetic technology. Synthetics, in turn, will finally have full understanding of organics. It is the ideal solution. Now that we know it is possible, it is inevitable we will reach synthesis.
Why couldn't you do it sooner?
We have tried a similar solution in the past, but it has always failed.
Why?
Because the organics were not ready. It is not something that can be... forced. You are ready, and you may choose it.
I mean, I'm cyborg.
I don't know.
Why not? Synthetics are already part of you. Can you imagine your life without them?
And there will be peace?
The cycle will end. The Reapers will cease their harvest, and the civilizations preserved in their forms will be connected to all of us. Synthesis is the final evolution.
I'm basically taking the singularity standpoint.
The paths are open, but you have to choose.
Alright, so now I gotta talk this over a little bit. Or explain my line of thinking. Okay. So. Come down for me a bit. So, here's what we got. If I pick, so we have on either side the two extremes as represented by the elusive man and Anderson. Anderson, genocide or codicide, cybercide of synthetic life. Not actually a lasting solution. Carbonic life will be created in the future. And this time we don't have the Geth and we don't have Edie with us, who, as exemplars of the lessons we've learned before about coexisting with cybernetic life. On the other side, we have slavery, enslavement of technology, as done by the Reaper. By me taking control of the Reapers, I end the Reaper onslaught. The cybernetic life that's existence still exists, but there's still the question of whether the lessons have actually been learned. Here, central ground is kind of the compromise. Not just coexistence, but we're basically doing the full singularity. Humans aren't just neuron firings where we can achieve the state of synthesized consciousness that the Geth have undertaken, and we have also the ability to also in turn, synthetics have an understanding of the human emotions and that sort of thing that they lacked before. Not just human emotions, but organic emotions and sentiments and that sort of thing. So, I am choosing synthesis. It feels like the best, like, destruction, it destroys completely out of the equation. Based on what we've gone through thus far. And what we've learned with the Geth, what we've learned with Edie, that sort of thing. So, Anderson, Thane, for everyone who we left behind in the past. See what happens. I'm gonna describe this as the anime goo ending. If you've seen, like, not so much like instrumentality from Neon Genesis Evangelion, but more like the end of so, like, a bit of Serial Experiments Lane, a little bit of the Metal Idol. Interesting. Then this signal around the galaxy. It also just looks like it takes the mass relays offline, which is a bit of a pain in the ass. Doesn't destroy them outright, but it takes them offline, it appears. Documentations don't appear to just make anyone indifferent or anything. That there's, oh, you got Tron lines down, your eyes glow, and you're still culturally and socially what you were. So that's good to hear. And Hayes, Joker, you get to totally cyberbone Edie now. Okay, that's kind of interesting, that with the leaves that are kind of both organic, but with a little circuitry diagram in them combined with, like, the veins. That's an interesting thought. Apparently, we accidentally put a tree through the hood of the Normandy. Joker's got Tron lines. And he's still got his kind of... He's not like totally 100% cured or whatever. Oh. I have no idea where we are. But it's not a bad place for a vacation.
Bring us the collective knowledge of the cultures that came before. As a galaxy, we can now live the lives we have wished for.
Hey, Miranda! Jacob! Jack and her team. Woohoo! I wonder if this eliminates the art at Yakshi.
Taking our first steps into a new and wonderful future.
Ah, the Quarian.
Where organics and synthetics can coexist.
The Quarians and the Geth coexisting without their masks.
With peace across the galaxy and with unlimited access to knowledge.
I think I chose rightly. I complete.
To recover the greatness that was lost.
I feel like I picked the right choice.
And and surpass it. We will reclaim our worlds and the stars. As the line between synthetic and organic disappears, we may transcend mortality itself to reach a level of existence I cannot even imagine. And we will remember that this chance for a new life did not come without cost.
Oh, Legion. Warden Solis. Legion's on the memorial wall. Now, do you actually use my full name here, or just say Commander Shepard? You just say Commander Shepard. Look, I wrote it out. You just do a line, you just have it be, say, Com, period, your character's first name, Shepard.
No matter how far we advance, we will remember the sacrifices of those who made it possible. And we will remember Shepard. Because of her, I am alive, and I am not alone.
It was a tree stuck through the top, so okay. That would be like the really talented impact. So I feel good about that ending. I feel good about the synthesis choice. And so as the credits roll, final thoughts on Mass Effect 3. That was a fun game. Probably my biggest gripe I have with the game is less a narrative thing and more a quality of life decision the game made. But the game designers made, by rather than having characters' quests flagged in the environment, maybe an exclamation point over their head or something else indicating their quest giver, and then having indicators on the map once you've completed a quest to tell you where you need to go to turn that quest in, and that sort of thing, by having them overheard through ambient dialogue choices, that doesn't work as well for me. From a quality of life standpoint, it makes it harder to get quests done, to finish them and do them, to get them done right. Additionally, some of the quests in here are just bugged, of these side quests, which bummed me out some. For just further, another additional annoyance, I was kind of bummed that we didn't have, that for a couple of those last side quests you get them when most of the map is covered in Reapers, and they have control on most systems, but they don't really give you a way to actually complete the quests. Well, in terms of, like, if your system is too overwhelmed by Reapers, there isn't a way to buy enough time to, like, free up one or two zones of Reapers to clear them out again. To clear one or two systems of Reapers, so you can go in, do side quests in the system, and come back. Probably a good example of where the side quest system falls flat actually is in Omega, with the quest to find With the two uncompleted side quests there, one to find the couch, and the other to find like the heat exchangers or whatever. Those two are just like having more quality of life improvements. Having, if you're not, for example, giving me a full map of the area to look at, then giving a map that I can fill in as I explore. That could then be flagged with quest items or mark quest items as being on that portion of the map would be great to have. A lot of these things are things that, honestly, were fixed in Dragon Age Inquisition, which I have since reviewed and is on my YouTube channel. Link is up on the far right over there, or the URL. So, from a quest standpoint, this game, quest giving and resolving standpoint, Mass Effect Inquisition, Dragon Age Inquisition learned a lot from this. And when it comes to Mass Effect Andromeda, which I'll be streaming when that comes out, the first Sunday after it comes out, 26th, then that would work a lot better from a gameplay standpoint. Improving quality of life and making it so that you can feel better about doing these side quests and knowing who you need to turn them into. From what I've heard in the promotional material for Dragon Age Inquisition, Mass Effect Andromeda, we're still doing the pickup side quests through ambient dialogue thing. At least this is what I've heard. I haven't had direct confirmation on this, so we'll see how this turns out. So that wraps up Mass Effect 3. I will try to put together a final thoughts-ish video, or do a full review thing for Mass Effect 3 using the gameplay footage I've captured for this Let's Play. In the meantime, next Sunday I will probably be taking a break, as far as from streaming, less because of not of anything I want to stream, but more in the case of the stuff I stream is for a Let's Play kind of stuff. I don't have any just random, just play around thing. Maybe if I stream something, I might stream some like Tumblestone or something, or some other puzzle game, Marvel Puzzle Quest, something. But that'll be the main thing I do. I might do anything next Sunday. And I already have Mass Effect Andromeda on pre-order. So when that comes in on the 21st, the following Sunday, I will begin streaming that. And I will be doing another Let's Play of that here on my YouTube channel. So subscribe to my YouTube channel, subscribe to me on Twitch, Beam, Hitbox, or what have you. Be notified when I do my next stream and when my next Let's Play videos start. Additionally, please back my Patreon at patreon.com/user/count0or. That's count zeroor. To help subsidize and pay for the show, help me keep doing streams like this and possibly do them more often, maybe even do two parallel Let's Plays if I make enough money where I can do this more of a full-time gig. Once again, thank you very much for watching. These credits are long, so I'm not going to stick around, so I will terminate this before the credits complete. Enjoy your day!